On behalf of Williamsburg Christian Academy, I'd like to welcome you today to our annual Thanksgiving Assembly, but our first annual Giving from the Heart of the Academy. Before we start together, I'd like to share a couple of scriptures with you. One in Psalm 69, verse 30, the psalmist says, "I will praise God's name in song and glorify him with thanksgiving." And then in Nehemiah 12, 27, the scripture says, "At the dedication of the wall of Jerusalem, the Levites were sought out from where they lived and were brought to Jerusalem to celebrate joyfully the dedication with songs of thanksgiving and with the music of cymbals, harps, and lyres." In the same way as WCA dedicates meals for families in need today, we celebrate with great joy and thanksgiving. In 2 Corinthians 9:11, the Apostle Paul says, "You will be made rich in every way so that you can be generous on every occasion, and through us your generosity will result in thanksgiving to God." God has made the school ministry so, so rich in so many ways. He has given our school family a deeper heart and ability to give to others, and we celebrate that, and a real genuine remembrance of our many blessings at Thanksgiving. At this time, please bow with me to open our assembly in prayer. Lord God, we thank you so much for the way that you bless us, but most importantly, who you are and the gift of salvation that you've given to us. And Lord, at this time of the year, we consider it a great privilege to come before you with thanksgiving. And Lord, particularly this year, to have a means and a method to extend your grace to others through our school families in the way of Thanksgiving meals. Lord, I pray that you would bless our time together today as we enjoy this season of Thanksgiving and the blessing of being together as family and friends. All these things we ask in your name. Amen. The first person that I'd like to introduce to you today for our assembly is an eighth grader, Evan Kerr, and he's going to come share with you the Thanksgiving proclamation.
Thanksgiving Proclamation, issued by George Washington at the request of Congress on October 3, 1789, by the President of the United States of America, a proclamation. Whereas it is the duty of all nations to acknowledge the providence of Almighty God, to obey his will, to be grateful for his benefits, humbly to implore his protection and favor. And whereas both houses of Congress have, by their joint committee, requested me to recommend to the people of the United States a day of public thanksgiving and prayer, to be observed by acknowledging with grateful hearts the many and signal favors of Almighty God, especially by affording them an opportunity peaceably to establish a form of government for their safety and happiness. Now, therefore, I do recommend and assign Thursday, the 26th of November next, to be devoted by these people of the United States to the service of the great and glorious being who is the beneficent author of all the good that was, that is, and that will be. That we may then all unite in rendering unto him our sincere and humble thanks for his kind care and protection of the people of the country previous to their becoming a nation, for the signal and manifold mercies and the favor, able interpositions of his providence in the course of and conclusion of the late war, for the great degree of tranquility, union, and plenty which we have since enjoyed, for the peaceable and rational manner in which we have been enabled to establish constitutions of government for our safety and happiness, and particularly the national one now lately instituted, for the civil and religious liberty with which we are blessed, and the means we have in acquiring and diffusing useful knowledge, and in general for all the great and various favors which he has pleased to confer upon us, and also that we may then unite in most humbly offering our prayers and supplications to the great Lord and ruler of nations, and beseech him to pardon our national and other transgressions, to enable us, whether in public or private stations, to perform our several and relative duties properly and punctually, to render our national government a blessing to all the people by constantly being a government of wise, just, and constitutional laws, discreetly and faithfully executed and obeyed, to protect and guide all sovereigns and nations, especially such as have shown kindness to us, and to bless them with good government, peace, and concord, to promote the knowledge and practice of true religion and virtue and the increase of science among them and us, and generally to grant unto all mankind such a degree of temporal prosperity as he alone knows to be best. Given under my hand at the city of New York, the third day of October, in the year of our Lord, 1789, George Washington.
At this time, it's a pleasure to introduce Dr. Diana Lindsay and her honors government class.
Good afternoon and welcome to our assembly. We're the senior honors government class, as Mrs. Martin said. Today I'm Ethan Martin, I'll be your master of ceremonies and I'll introduce my classmates to you. First of all, we have Caroline Rao.
Good afternoon. Welcome to our Thanksgiving assembly today. This is a senior government class taught by Dr. Lindsay. I think I can speak for the whole government class when I say Dr. Lindsay has made this year one of our most memorable, and for our senior class, the best final year we could ask for. So far for this year in government class, we have been reading the Federalist Papers, a collection of papers published by the Founding Fathers in order to defend the purpose of our unity as a nation. We discuss Alexander Hamilton's views on the potential existence of a Bill of Rights. We talk about James Madison's philosophical thinking about becoming a republic, and John Jay's memorable additions regarding building a proper government for ourselves. Reading the papers, we try to apply the author's ideas to contemporary times. We have talked for days about several different subjective concepts, constantly learning from the primary source and ourselves. Today, we will be reading the Bill of Rights, 10 civil liberties we hold as Americans and as human beings.
Next, we have Jonathan DeMelkin and Lynn Dunn.
We the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity, do ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America.
Next, we have Kelly Meyer.
We are thankful as an American people. We are thankful as American Christians. And we are thankful as WCA students for our Constitution and our Bill of Rights.
At this point in our presentation, the next 10 students will introduce themselves and the amendment that they've been assigned.
Good evening, I'm Tyler Hutton, and I will be reading the First Amendment, which says, Congress shall make no laws regarding to religion, regarding to freedom of speech, regarding to freedom of press, and regarding to the meeting of peaceful assemblies.
My name is Zach Alexander, and I'm reading Amendment number 2. A well-regulated militia being necessary to the security of a free state, the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed.
My name is Keenan Gasway, and I'll be doing Amendment 3. No soldier shall, in time of peace, be quartered in any house without the consent of the owner, nor in time of war, but in a manner to be prescribed by law.
My name is Brian Williams. I'll be reading Amendment 4, which says, the right of the people to be secure in their persons, houses, papers, and effects against unreasonable searches and seizures shall not be violated, and no warrants shall issue but upon probable cause supported by oath or affirmation, and particularly describing the place to be searched and the persons or things to be seized.
I'm Ryan Prince, and I'll be reading the Fifth Amendment, and it reads, no person shall be held to answer for a capital or otherwise infamous crime unless on a presentment or indictment of a grand jury, except in cases arising in the land of naval forces or in the militia when in actual service time or war of a public danger. Nor shall any person be the subject of the same offense or to be twice put into jeopardy of life or limb, nor shall be compelled to any crime case to be witness against himself, nor deprived of life, liberty, or prosperity without due process of law, nor shall private property be taken from public without use or justice or just compensation.
My name is Megan Smith, and I will be reading Amendment 6. In all criminal prosecutions, the accused shall enjoy the right to a speedy and public trial by an impartial jury of the state and district wherein the crime shall have been committed, which district shall have been previously ascertained by law, and to be informed of the nature and cause of the accusation, to be confronted with the witness against him, to have compulsory process for obtaining witnesses in his favor, and to have the assistance of counsel for his defense.
I'm Jalen Ponzo, and I'm reading Amendment 7. In suits at common law, where the value in controversy shall exceed $20, the right by trial by jury shall be preserved, and no fact tried by jury shall be otherwise reexamined in any court of the United States, then according to the rules of the common law.
My name is John Sawin, and Amendment 8 reads, excessive bail shall not be required, nor excessive fines imposed, nor cruel and unusual punishments inflicted.
My name is Dirk Williams, and I'll be reading Amendment number 9. The enumeration in the Constitution of certain rights shall not be construed to deny or disparage others retained by the people.
My name is Tanika Pierce, and I'll be reading Amendment number 10. The powers not delegated to the United States by the Constitution, nor prohibited by it to the states, are reserved to the states respectively, or to the people.
To close our presentation, we'll have Kathleen come up. Kathleen Smith.
We, the students of Williamsburg Christian Academy, are thankful to be citizens of the United States of America, where we are delegated these inalienable rights, and scholars at WCA. And on behalf of the government class, I'd like to wish you a happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you.
next we are going to have our preschool. If you'll bear with me, there are a lot of them. So preschoolers, come forward. I'd like to reintroduce one of our seniors. Lynn Dunn is going to come and interpret a song for us in sign language.
I remember the moment, I remember the pain. I was only a girl, but I grew up that day. Tears were falling, I know you saw me. When I met you, oh, this time.
can say is wow. Wow. At this time, we're going to have our first and second grade students come up, and they're going to sing May the Name of God Be Praised. Our second through fifth grade are going to sing, We Praise You, O God, Our Redeemer.
Thank you. I said earlier we had a little luncheon for our pastors and for Mr. Boyette and for Dina, who came to visit today. We had a little luncheon across the way in the library, and I said to them what I'm going to say to you. I am so happy this day has finally arrived. We have been working on this project as a school family for a few months, and it has just been a privilege to see it finally come together. Several years ago, I was a parent, a sophomore parent rep at St. Mary's High School in Annapolis, Maryland. And we kind of came up with this idea that we're so blessed in our communities, and there are so many people that don't have what we have. So back then, we put together an Easter dinner at the time. But then when I came here in this position a year ago, I started talking to Laura Lane and Cindy Colley on my staff, and now Becky Birch as well. And we knew that this is a special place, and that this academy could really do something special if we all work together. So as one of the projects to celebrate our 35th anniversary, the first being Grandparents' Day, which honored our legacy and our traditions and our families, that was the first step. This step is the opportunity to say thank you. Thank you to God for all that we have. And it's a way to give back to our communities. I read a little quote the other day a pastor had written, and it says, "Feeling gratitude and not expressing it is like wrapping a present and not giving it." Well, thanks to all of you working together, we have 100 presents ready to give, and I am so privileged and so proud of all of you, from our little preschoolers who made the most adorable little turkeys to put in each bag, and on the back it says, "From our family to yours, Williamsburg Christian Academy." We have created 100 complete Thanksgiving dinners that are going to go off to other people in our community. So I thank you all for your participation in this. We pray that this will become an annual tradition now here at the Academy. Just 35 years young, we've got a long ways to go. Who knows, maybe next year. I call Mrs. Randall now Mrs. Cornbread, and there's Mrs. Cranberry Sauce, and Mr. So they're all by their food item now. So I'll try and mix it up for you. Don't you love kindergarten? So I once again add my thanks to the pastors that are involved in this, to Dina Wells from Grove Christian, and to Walter Boyette representing Farm Fresh Supermarkets. Again, this is a great project, and you can all be very proud of it. I've invited the pastors to come and bless these meals, and before they come up, I wanted to introduce one of our own, not a stranger to most of us know him. He's a dad here, and he's a spiritual leader in our community and in our school, and it's my privilege to introduce Travis Watson to come up and lead us in a blessing. Thank you.
Woo! Good times, right? Well, you know it's a special occasion when I wear my fancy pants, and they are on today, so there's been a lot of thanks and a lot of gratitude shared, and also I want to make sure we thank you as well, Pam, because God puts a lot of things on different people's hearts, but if we don't do anything with it, it's kind of moot. And so thank you for being faithful and following through and just spearheading this project. I really, really appreciate your heart. Yeah. We're, as typical with pastors, I could talk for a couple hours and not get bored, but you would, so I'm not here to give you a sermon, but I do want to just say one thing to you real quick before we pray over these bags of food. Being poor, being broken, it does not have a prejudice. It affects everyone. It doesn't affect one particular denomination over another, one particular ethnicity over another. It affects everyone. Christ in the scriptures over 300 times refers to the poor and to social justice and to caring for the needy. In fact, you cannot separate the true gospel and caring for the poor. They go hand in hand. In multiple places in the gospels, he says, "You will always have the poor with you." And when we think of the poor, a lot of times, I know in my own mind growing up, when you read it in scripture and stuff, we associate it with like the beggar at the gate or with the person with the cardboard sign or the cup at the intersection. The poor actually is much different than just those expressions. The poor is individuals that are working 3 and 4 jobs just trying to survive. The poor and the needy are those that are just broken in their spirit emotionally, just wondering if it's worth getting out of bed because they don't know where their next meal is going to come from. The poor is all around us, and it would do us good to celebrate this more than just once a year and to remember that Christ said you're always going to have the poor. So be active, be present, be alert. One of my most favorite passages, as well as one of my most convicting passages as of late, is out of 1 John, where Jesus says through the Apostle John, he says this, and I'm paraphrasing it for you, but those of you who have means, you have the ability to meet a need, and you see that in your brothers and sisters around you, yet you do nothing, how can you say that the love of God abides in you? And one of the things I just love about this event is that it's not about a church. It's not about a school. It's not even about the families that have given a lot to make today happen. Today is about people saying, we love because he first loved us. And so thank you on behalf of God and on behalf of his son for loving the poor and for being there for the needy. I'm going to ask the ministers that are present, and even if you're part of that list that was mentioned or not, as a minister, or as a lay leader, maybe in an organization, if you want to come up with me as I lead us in prayer, I would ask you to do that now and just kind of come and stand around this just beautiful scenery, including you, Mrs. Martin. You look very nice today. But if you guys could just kind of come on up here and surround these bags, and if you feel led to, just put your hands on them as well, that God would just bless this as we pray. I'll stand by the microphone and lead us in prayer over here. And I'm going to ask, you know, this isn't more holy just because pastors are praying over it. All right, don't think that this is now somehow super spiritually because we're up here. God honors your prayer as much as he does us. So I'm going to ask as we pray up here that you would also join us in prayer, whether silently or vocally or whatever you're comfortable in your prayer as well. But let's not just say thank you, but let's also ask that the families that will partake of this will not only taste delicious food, but that they would taste love and that they would taste grace. So let's just bow for a moment and ask our Father to be in this place. Father, you truly are so good. Your kindness is beyond anything that we could even come close to measuring. We have these seasons in our life, Father, and in our community, there are people that experience it more frequently, maybe than us here, that just feels very dark and very heavy and sometimes hopeless and sometimes even as if we're all alone and no one cares and nothing matters, and is there a purpose to any of this? Father, my prayer for these meals that have been provided is quite simply, first and foremost, that you would somehow get glory through this, that your name would be made great, that you would be lifted up, and that for one brief moment, people would know that they are loved, that your creation would know that they have value and that they do have purpose and that they do matter. And humbly, I would ask that their stomachs would be full, but even more than that, that their hearts would be full, that for a moment you could touch the lives of men and women and sons and daughters, of the old and the young, of the single and of the married and of the divorced and of the individual that's just wondering why, that you would touch those lives, Father, and in this they would feel your love above everything else. Father, I pray that you would bless the hands that have taken the time to prepare this, that you would smile favorably on our wonderful friends at Farm Fresh for their generosity towards the poor and towards the community in which you've placed them. I pray that their company would experience a blessing like never before. And I pray for the families and the individuals and those that have been involved in this project that have taken out of their time to donate and to collect and to bag and to set up and organize and put all of this together, that they would know that you smile with delight because they care about what you care about. And Father, lastly, I would just ask that this would be more than a once-a-year Thanksgiving time where we pause to care for the other people around us in our world and in our community, but that we would live with eyes wide open, arms extended wide, always willing, always ready to give a hand, to give whatever means you have provided us with to let others know that they matter and that together we can make a difference in our world and in our community. I thank you for what you are orchestrating and what you are doing in the people present in this place. I can only imagine how much you are smiling in this moment from your throne, looking down at these people that have gathered to celebrate you and to give. How that must just delight your heart. So, Father, thank you for blessing us. Thank you for allowing us air to breathe, for giving us a place to be in this moment that is convenient and warm and covered and sheltered and in a place where our children can be educated, and on we could go giving you thanks for this time of year. We just want you to know our hearts are truly grateful because it is all about you, for you, and to you, and because of you. And I ask and pray all of this in the only name that has ever mattered, the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
To wrap up our time today, and our time is a little bit shorter than we thought, so we're going to do something a tiny bit differently. We want to also extend our prayers of thanks for all of our new students that have come to WCA this year and have just gotten right into the school family and been so much a part of us. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to call up all the preschool students to gather around, and their director of preschool, Michelle Flanagan, her daughter, Lindsay. I'd also like to call up Becky Birch and Carol Kerr and Olivia Nice and Emily Jutris and Michael Prezioso and Isaac Davis. These folks represent all our departments, and we were going to read out all the names of our new students to thank God for that, and we don't have time. So I'm going to ask the four people that we're going to pray to just pray in order. We're going to have Lindsay Flanagan thank the Lord for all of our preschoolers that you see. We're going to have Carol Kerr pray for all of our new elementary students as Thanksgiving for them. And Olivia Nice was going to read names, but now Emily Jutris is going to pray, and followed by Michael Prezioso, who would have been reading names, but now Isaac Davis is going to pray. So we're just going to, those four folks are going to pray for all of our new students.
Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this day, and thank you for bringing everyone here safely. Thank you for the 40 new preschool students that you have added to our school. I pray that they grow not only academically, but also spiritually. I pray that they will excel in all they do and give all the glory to you.
Will you pray with me, please? Heavenly Father, our hearts are rejoicing from the blessing of music and the blessing of your spoken word and the blessing of this country. And we thank you for that. And Lord, we thank you that we're able to share that with many new students this year. Lord, I know that they're here in your will. It could be just for 1 year. It could be for the rest of their school career. But we pray that while they're here, that we would help you in meeting their needs. We know some of them have been sent here by people who have prayed and loved and sacrificed. And we pray that you would bless those who are contributing to their education. And Lord, we just pray that you would bless them and make them part of this community of faith, and that you would help them to grow, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Ilio Boyko, Killian Burden, Margaret Dawson, Matthew Kofer, Madison Schmidt, Jimmy Clark, Elena Laris, Leah Salvages, Brendan Schweichler, Logan Winger, Braxton Claiborne, Ashley Donahue, Lindsay Flanagan, Evan Kerr, and Madison Loftus.
Dear Lord, I thank you for bringing everyone here safely today, and bless all those who are traveling for Thanksgiving. And thank you for all the new students you brought to WCA, and I pray this experience is going to help them grow in you and in school. Help us make them feel welcomed and protect everyone on their journey home. In Jesus' name, amen.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this day, Lord. Lord, we thank you so much for leading all of the new high school students, Lord, to WCA so that they may walk and learn more about you, Lord. I ask, Lord, just to help them put your hands around each and every one of them, Lord, giving them your protection, your love, Lord, and your guidance, Lord, because we all need it, Lord. Lord, I ask, Lord, just to help us and bless us, Lord, in our daily lives, in our school, with our work and tests, Lord, that you may just put a calmness over us, Lord, and that we may all remember, Lord, that you came here for us, Lord, that each of us matter. Lord, we thank you so much for what you have done for us, Lord. We thank you for sending your son down here to die on the cross for each and every one of us, Lord. And we all love you, Lord. And I ask you, Lord, that you may just bless us and protect us. In Jesus' name, amen.
And just to close our program, what we'd like to do is wish you and your family a happy Thanksgiving, and go in peace, and continue to remember the poor. You're dismissed.